Hey everyone. So yesterday I filmed a video which explained how to set up a Zap. So when you tag a task in Asana, it automatically sends an email like this. So we can send this email to a contact. The challenge we had in the video was that the task in Asana only has the email address for the contact. So originally the contact has filled in a form. The form only has the email address. And so we want to also pull the other information from HubSpot, which has the first name, last name, maybe company name, maybe other details for the contact. So right now in the customer feedback project here in the list in Asana, you can see here for this particular comment that we've received as customer feedback, can you offer dark mode? We only have the email address. So we want to go into Zapier. We're going to add this step here in Zapier to find the contact. And then we're going to pull that information and use it inside our email so that when the contact gets sent the email, we can include their first name here. And we can also include other details if we wanted to in the message. So it's pretty simple to do it. If you go back and you look at the video from yesterday, you'll be able to see how we set up the tag trigger here, the tag added trigger, and how we had the send email trigger. Now what we're going to do, I'll just go back a step. We have this Zap and we're going to add in a step in the middle here. We're going to search for HubSpot, and you could search for any kind of email marketing platform you've got, or database, CRM, or anything you're currently using, ActiveCampaign or MailChimp or whatever it is. And you find that here, and you basically need to do a search step or a find step. And we can type in find a contact. Here we go, find contact. Continue, we connect up the HubSpot account. So first we have to find the property. We've got to select the email property. So what I like to do is just copy paste the name for the property, which is contact information email. Otherwise it can be quite hard to find the property, because when you do a search in Zapier for HubSpot properties, it's not very accurate. I don't know how it decides what to show here, but it's obviously showing a lot more than what we're after. So I can do Command F or Control F, and then I'm going to type that in here like this into the find function in the browser. And then that'll help me a little bit. So I found the contact information email confirmed. And then the second one, contact information email here. So we select this one. That's what we want. We want the one that just says email. That's it. So we've got that first property there. And then we're going to do a search. We want to say what we're going to search in that email property. And so we're going to select the email. I'm going to just do a little at symbol to quickly find the email. There's the text value. And then if we wanted to do any searches on any other values, we could do that here as well, but we won't. And we don't want to create a contact, so I'm just going to leave that unticked. And then let's test this step. Cool. So we've got the details here and all the information about the contact. So that's great. So now we click continue, and then we go to this email step, and then let's add in the name here. And so we're going to select next to hello, and then we're going to grab from the find contact. We're going to get the first name. There we go. Satele. And then we can say a little bit about the company name as well. I think we've got a company name. So I hope this message went well. I just want to take a moment to express the heartfelt thanks for sharing your feedback with us. I'm just adding this in as an example, but obviously you wouldn't necessarily have or want to include their company name. How's it all going at? But I just want to have another field I can throw in here for this video. So we'll say company name. There we go. Part of the Jedi Order there. And then I'll put a little question mark and then let you know that we're actioning the feedback. And that's it. And then we can click continue. And then I'm going to do a test step, but I'm going to just remove the email from my test so that I don't send an email to the person. And I'll just put my personal, I'll put the team email there actually. And we've got the team one. Okay, continue, test step. And then let's go to the team email account. There's the email. Here we go. So tell it. How's it all going at the Jedi Order? Any offer dark mode, etc. Okay, awesome. So that's, it's that simple. So now with this find contact in HubSpot, and you could do this with many different CRMs or email marketing systems, or just need a step where you're looking up the email address that we've got here. And then we then can just add that into the email template. So this will work automatically. It'll always pull the person's first name and the company name details as well. So I hope that's been useful. Let me know if you have any questions about this. I can go a lot more detailed or deeper or experiment with other things. It's really just up to what you're interested in and what you want to know more about. So please feel free to share in the comments. And if this video has been useful, please like it and share it with other people that might find it helpful. And of course, subscribe for future content along these kind of topics around HubSpot and Zapier and all kinds of digital marketing software as well. So thank you very much for watching and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.